Hello, my name is Bo Horn. I'm currently serving First United Methodist Church of Manning. Back in the 50s, when my grandfather and my family had a family meal, and my grandfather asked me to pray grace over the meal, and I used the Lord's Prayer. And when I finished the prayer, my granddaddy told me, "Son, you're going to be a preacher one day." My primary reason for becoming a pastor is I started out as a lay speaker, and I kept getting calls to go to different churches in the district in which I live. I just felt led to go into the ministry through that, and I started out with the guidance of Brother Joe Solomon at Lee Joyner Church. He guided me through it. And he asked me, he said, "Have you talked to Francis about this?" I said, "No, I wanted to talk to you first." And so he said, "Well, you need to talk to Francis." And so I went to Francis and told her that I felt the call to ministry. And she said, "Well, I don't get that. I'll have to pray about that." And so it took 6 months, and finally she said, "Well, if you're going into the ministry, don't you think you ought to do something about it?" At the time I went into the ministry, I was a full-time firefighter for the city of Monroe, and I pastored part-time at a little church, Woodlawn, out in West Monroe. They gave me a lot of guidance because I was very naive. But I learned about ministry from pastoring that church. Larry Stafford one time caught me in a situation where my lay leader was commenting at a district meeting about how nice and good my sermon was for that particular Sunday morning. And Larry Stafford turned around and said, "Bo, is that the children's sermon that I gave you last week?" So I was just going to say that one of the reasons why I got into ministry was because I heard Larry Stafford preach one time, and I knew the church needed help. It's been a wonderful journey. I kind of feel in some ways like Job. I'm a cancer survivor. Back in 2011, I was diagnosed with throat cancer, and I went through cancer treatment, never thinking that I'd ever be able to preach again, but God had plans for me to do it. And I moved to First United Methodist in Manning, and after I got there in July, the September after that, I had a major heart attack, and I had to be airlifted into Shreveport. And I was shocked 15 times on the way to the hospital. And so after that, now when I wake up in the evenings to have to go to the restroom, I do not have to have a night light because I glow in the dark. Some of the ones that I want to thank in my journey in ministry, of course, is Joe Solomon, who is no longer with us. This other person that I want to thank in my journey, of course, is my bride. She has stuck with me through thick and thin. She has seen the bad times, but she's also experienced the joy with me through all these years. Larry Stafford and Bob Burgess, Terry Love, all of these guys are my buddies, and I love them dearly, and they have helped me along the way in a tremendous way, and I'm so thankful for them. It has been a good journey, but they're losing a wonderful preacher with me retiring, but it's a sorry dog that will not wag his own tail. God bless.